anxiety. Kind of what I've learned and how I've got to this point where I think I'm pretty much over it. Usually I've talked to other people. A lot of people seem to agree the first time is the worst. You don't really know what's happening. Up until that point, you've just been living your normal life. Like everything's fine. And then, boom, it kind of hits you. And you're like, what the hell? And the next time, you're like, oh, I'm just having an anxiety attack. I'm not gonna die. And to be honest, if you've had anxiety attacks, I feel like at some point, you just reach the point where you're not afraid to die, where you're like, I'll take a heart attack. Just quit bullshitting me. So anyway, I think the first turning point of taking back control for me when I had anxiety was not trying to fight it. Like, if you feel feeling of anxiety rising up in you, I'd always go like, push it away, fight it, don't let it happen, fight it, like, don't let it happen. And a turning point is when one day after years I just had enough and I was like, hit me, come into me, I want to feel more of it. I don't care, just let's do this. Like, you wanna go, let's see where we can take this. And I think when you're holding back, you're kind of creating that anxiety. And so when you say, come on, hit me, your body kind of says, like, well, it's fight or flight. And you just want, you want this? You want this feeling? Like, and it kind of, it's one way to give you the power, if you just embrace it. And you gotta kind of be like, so what? You feel something new, like I can't breathe? So what, I can't breathe? My heart's racing, it's murmuring, it's doing weird things. So what? It's no big deal. That's kind of interesting, actually. I'm dizzy, so what? It's a big deal about being dizzy. I like it. Used to have kids push me around on a playground to get this feeling. Now I can just have it for free. And that kind of takes the power away from it. That's actually the huge one. Another thing is, you know, of course you gotta have a good diet, but I've noticed, and this is kind of weird, is probiotics. Taking a probiotic really gets me to a point where I don't have anxiety. I can go to any situation and just walk in, and I just don't get that feeling where I have to fight it or I even think about it, which is weird. And I don't want to play up a placebo, whereas especially with anxiety, you're really susceptible placebos. Simply because if someone comes up to you and they say, take this M&M, and as long as you take this M&M, your anxiety will go away. Well, it's the idea of the M&M that's giving you comfort. The M&M's not doing anything. But you knowing you have that M&M, meaning I can take that M&M and I'm not going to get anxiety, it makes you not get anxiety just because you're comforted by the idea of the M&M. The M&M doesn't actually do anything. But having said that, when it comes to probiotics, I always wondered if it was a placebo. But it seems to be more. And they show how your gut health is related to your mind. And when I take a probiotic, especially the right probiotics, they're starting to discover, like, they can get the right bacteria to help, like neuroprobiotics. Anyways, I found a good probiotic and was taking it and went and stood up in a wedding, which a couple years ago I had a what's happening anxiety attack. And one of those first ones, it wasn't my first ever, but it was my first in like 3 years. It just hit me at a wedding. And for some reason I got it in my head, like I can't do weddings, I get anxiety attacks. And now that was just the opposite of the placebo effect. Whereas, you know, the M&M's giving me comfort, now the weddings are giving me discomfort. And so I had to stand in actually two friends' weddings. The first one I just toughed it out. But the second one, I was taking this a daily probiotic. And I had been having bad anxiety before I started taking the probiotic. And it came time for the wedding, and I just remember being like, I feel cool. And I don't feel comforted by having some imaginary M&M with me or anything. I have to go to this wedding, and it's gonna happen, and I feel zero nervousness. Zero anxiety nervousness. Like, I just feel like a normal person. And the only thing I really have to explain for that is probiotic. Because I was definitely in, just like a week or two before, just in this anxiety state. And I knew that probiotics before had helped me in the past, but I actually looked up like a probiotic for anxiety, which I don't think legally they can say, but I kind of just searched for it, and they're like, this is a normal probiotic for normal digestive health and all this. And it the actual probiotic didn't say anything about, you know, helping with anxiety or stuff, or being a neuro probiotic, because I doubt legally you can say that. I don't think the research is there yet. But they're kind of like, all the sites were kind of like, nudge, nudge, wink, wink, take this one. And totally felt cool, calm, and relaxed. And have since. Even with, like, today. Like, right now, actually, because of this cold that won't go away and is in my chest, like, I feel like I can't breathe all day. And so I took a Claritin D to try and kind of just dry myself up and just get it so I can breathe. And so Claritin D's give me a head rush, like, all day. So now I can't breathe and I have a head rush. which, if I was in an anxiety state, that'd be a nightmare. Like, I wouldn't be able to function. But instead, I'm just, I mean, I'd be able to function now because I'd just go to my who cares, whatever, I'll just take it attitude and then just embrace it. But I don't even have to do that because I'm just, feel fine. Feel annoyed I can't breathe. Feel annoyed I'm dizzy from the Claritin D, but other than that, I'm out in the world and I'm fine. And I'm making my way. I don't know. I hope that helps. And if that doesn't help you, I hope the brushing does. Alright. I gots to get back to work. Alright. I gotta get to bed so I can get back to work. This job is gonna go forever, I swear. You've been 1 week away from finishing for about a month. That's how bad it sucks. How slow we're going. But alright. I'm going to bed. You should too. Unless you're awake and you're just here for the ASMR and relaxation. In that case, watch a comforting video. Watch, watch Gibby's or GB's new zombie one. That's pretty restful. Or watch some of Ghetto's tapping. Ghetto ASMR. That stuff's incredible how fast he can tap. Alright. Get out of here. For real. See ya.